is another gentleman. You have seen him on very, very many shows on various networks. In fact, I had to pull out my notes, you know, but this is a strange character to me. I don't know. He's a strange guy, you know, but he's an awesome guy too. You know, we love him. We love his work. We love what this gentleman does. He is considered to be the founding father of the vampire culture and mythology. You have seen him on MTV's Oddville. You have seen him on A&E. You've seen him on CNN, Discovery Channel, Travel Channel's Ghost Adventures. You name it, he's been a lot. You know, he talks about different things too. You know, strange phenomena, the paranormal, you know. And if you didn't know what a Fang Smith was, I'm gonna tell you the truth. I really didn't know. I've heard it before. But I was shocked. This man's got a store in New York, a Fang Smith. So we're gonna let him explain all that to us. We want to welcome good old Father Sebastian right here to the show.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, sir. Did you bring me a pair of fangs?
Oh, we gotta bring it to the dental office.
Oh, boy. Man, I thought maybe you had a pair all set, you know, everything. And well, you used to be a dental assistant, right?
I used to be a dental technician.
Okay, all right.
And my grandfather was an orthodontist.
Wow.
And my aunt is a practicing dentist, so it's in my blood. Okay. And over the years, when I, you know, basically the story started as I wanted fangs for my prom and my girlfriend, and I asked my grandfather, and he laughed at me, and he was like, "You're gonna go to hell!" And I'm like, so I found a Fang Smith, and we went and got our fangs, and we went to the prom as vampire king and queen.
Wow, wow. And what gave you the drive? I mean, of course, explain, but what gave you the drive to actually, you know, at least, even in a lot of shows that you've been on, you know, itself, what gives you the drive to do what you do?
What gives me the drive to do what I do is basically my love of vampire mythology and how to apply it to the real world. And the paranormal, the spirituality,
sure,
and the magical diversity of the vampire myth is reflected in the people that I make fangs for. I've made fangs all over the world in 27 sure. countries.
Wow.
I've made fangs in Africa, and Europe, South America, and North America, all in 1 week once. And just to get to meet this, my fang shop's like a barbershop. So you get to have all these great conversations with people and meet the locals and go into the culture and really find out why these people want fangs and relate to the vampire mythology.
Wow, that is just amazing, you know. And just tell us something about vampires, your mindset of vampires.
The modern vampire mythos really evolved in the 19th century with Victorian literature, and there's three great influences. The first great influence is, of course, Bram Stoker's Dracula.
Mm-hmm.
The second is Anne Rice and the Vampire Chronicles, which is getting its own TV show on Hulu.
Yes.
And, of course, Vampire the Masquerade, the role-playing game back in the early 90s, was like Dungeons and Dragons, but instead of a warrior, or a mage, or a thief, or a cleric, you would play a clan of vampires that was like a character class. So you'd have like the artists, and they're coming out with a new... Vampire the Masquerade took all the vampire mythologies and put it into one. And from there, a vampire subculture was born, where people could identify with vampire culture. So I translated a lot of the mythology into kind of taking self-help and culture and tradition and kind of codifying it to a book called The Black Veils. Okay, and I started my career in New York City.
Yep.
I moved to the Bronx.
Boogie down Bronx.
And I'm a Bronx bomber. So
there we go.
I'm a Yankee fan.
Home sweet home.
And I grew up in Yankee Stadium, the old one.
Wow, that's
and,
awesome.
And started to put my fang shop in a Halloween store.
Yeah.
And then, you know, when Blade came out and Lost Boys and all these movies, people wanted to take this mythology and make it tangible as a subculture.
Sure, sure.
So vampires are generally in three categories in the lifestyle. There's lifestylers are people that are basically aesthetic oriented.
Okay.
Okay, and culture oriented. They follow like old world tradition and treating ladies like ladies and gentlemen like gentlemen.
Sure,
and
sure.
And then there's the energy vampires who are kind of like a spirituality and they work with energy flows and whatnot. And then there's the blood-drinking vampires, which are slightly controversial, but it's all consensual.
Yeah. Wow. Blood-drinking vampires.
Yeah, they're
know.
Called sanguines.
Oh, wow.
But that's usually in a couple, monogamous, you know, very, very safety-oriented. And it's actually not as common as you think, but when it's done with great respect.
It's done with great respect. What goes into that process of making some good things?
Well, first of all, ritual is a very important thing to me.
Right.
And making a pair of fangs is, of course, a dental prosthetic. Okay, so I'm not a dentist, so I can't make permanent fangs.
Right.
I have a dentist that I can refer people to, and we have a company called EternalFangs.com,
right.
And you can get permanently implanted fangs. But wow. The fangs that I make are prosthetic caps, and it begins with an oath, and the people put their hands up like Ozzy Osbourne, and they have to make an oath that they will not eat or sleep with their fangs, and they can drink and smoke with their fangs, the yays and nays of fang making, and they laugh and giggle.
Can't do any neck biting or anything?
Well, my insurance waiver won't really cover that. But what people do in their bedrooms is their business.
Right, right. You know, it's got to be some neck biting, you know. Yeah. I remember the good Vincent Price, you know, movies and everything, you know, from just, you know, vampire
old school.
Stuff, the old school stuff.
Black and white.
Oh, yes, sir.
Those are great.
Those are great, great movies, you know.
Before my time.
Hey, you know, good stuff. You know, that's very creative, Boss Bass. That is just awesome. I think, and your store is actually in the city, right? In Manhattan?
Well, actually, the store is I'm not there anymore.
Okay.
I'm relocated to Los Angeles.
To LA. Okay.
I'm working in a great oddity shop called Memento Mori. Yes.
Okay.
It's on Wilcox.
Okay.
And I'm working on a couple projects with the CW and
awesome.
And ghost hunting and with fangs.
Excellent, excellent. What kind of projects on CW?
I can't really talk about
it. Can't talk about it at this time.
But
okay.
It's going to be for the Lost Boys premiere.
Awesome. You've heard them right here on Positive Progression TV. You know, and share your social media.
You can find me at Father Sebastian on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And FatherSebastian.com. It's Father Sebastian with two A's to celebrate my Dutch heritage. IAAN.
All right. Father Sebastian right here on Positive Progression. Continued success to you.
Thanks
for
your
time.
You as well.
All right, and like the fangs, man.
Come on down to my shop and see me.
Oh, I am, man. You know, I'm just scared to walk in there. I don't know what they have, you know.
You'll leave better than you came.
Yeah. You've seen her on the wonderful ABC hit show, How to Get Away with Murder. We've seen her on Grey's Anatomy. We've seen her on Bounty Hunter, okay? List of credits go on and on and on and on. Gloria Garayua.
That's me. Hello, everyone. Thank you, Chris.
You're quite welcome. I'm so happy that you're here. So happy to know that you're from my native hometown. Okay,
that's
the Boogie Down Bronx.
No, it's
not.
It's cool.
You know, I think it's very cool.
To have a Bronx site here in
you
LA
know,
by
you know
my
a little
side.
Something about Fordham Road. You know a little something
that's
about
my
Tremont.
Hood.
See, her. Okay, see, yep. See, I did my homework. I knew.
Thank you.
I knew, you know, what was happening. You know, I knew something was going on. Gloria. We really appreciate you coming on the show.
I'm happy to be
Thanks
here.
Thanks so much.
Thank
it's fun
you.
To be in LA to see wonderful people like yourself. Lots of many things going on with you, okay?
Yeah.
So talk to us about some of your projects and things that you're
sure.
working on.
Okay.
And I know you're rushing to the set right now.
See, always.
Good working woman.
Always working. So I do have a lot going on. So last year I was blessed enough to book Reckoning.
Wow.
Which is a show that is being produced by Sony Studios.
Okay.
It went straight to series, 10 episodes. We shot in Australia, which was really exciting.
Wow. How did you enjoy that?
Oh, I loved it. Honestly, I didn't want to come back, but everything I have is here, so I had to come back.
Great food out there.
Great food, great animals, great people, great feel-good energies, great oceans, right? Anyway, sure. So spent 4 months out there, came back, and so what they're doing now from what I don't know much about the show right now, but I guess they're still trying to get their distribution deal going.
Sure.
But I know it'll get on the air, and I'm waiting to hear if there's a season two because I'd love to go back. But I played a really cool character. So I played a detective, and I've played a detective before, but this detective felt different to me, as they all should, right? You can't be playing the same character all over the place. But it's about a serial killer, and my character gets assigned to this very cool case about the serial killer. And my partner has been on this case longer than I, and he's obsessed with the case. So really, my coming in is like finding the balance between where I can fit into this case, because he's obsessed with it, but we're partners.
Awesome.
And it's how I help with the serial killer, whether we find him or don't find him, or her. Right?
Nice
can't
little running
can't
twist
give much
to
away.
It. Yeah. And let's back up for just a second. How did you get into acting? I mean, what was your passion to want to go into acting?
So I wanted to be an actress ever since I was a kid, but I honestly thought that actors were aliens. I thought that they lived in this, you know, two-dimensional screen and you were born into it, or you came from outer space and landed on TV. Like, I didn't understand that you can learn it, grow it, develop it.
Right.
And partly that might be why I'm a teacher. I'm also an acting teacher.
That's awesome.
Because you need to have some talent and some gifts, sure, obviously, sure. Something that draws you to this.
Sure.
That can't be taught. Right. But how to go about human observation and how to be compassionate and have empathy, you know, that can be taught. Beats can be taught, things like that.
Right.
So I went into acting late in life, you know, because I thought that this wasn't something that I could do. I wanted to be a doctor. And my entire track was science up until about the age of 17 when it was time to choose a major in college. And I thought, right, I really want to try this thing because I've been good at it. You know, school plays, choir,
sure,
dance class.
Sure.
I was always good at it.
Yeah. Where'd
got
you go
compliments.
To school?
St. Nicholas Tolentine Elementary School,
okay.
St. Catherine Academy High School,
awesome.
Long Island University for
she
my acting degree.
LIU,
yeah.
People.
Yeah,
okay.
And I went to private school my whole life. I don't know how my parents afforded that growing up.
Well,
in
guess
the Bronx,
what? I went to private school too.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was tough.
Yeah, it is
very
tough.
Strict.
Tuition's
Boy
expensive.
Strict.
And, but I think parents, especially parents coming from somewhere else, really want to give their kids the best opportunity so they pay what they gotta pay.
That's right.
And so, yeah, so I became an actress because I realized that just like a doctor heals people, an actor can also affect people. By affecting someone's emotions, hopefully you can change their mind and their perspective.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm still healing and I'm still helping, but just
right,
in a different way, through entertainment.
Well, yeah. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Continue success.
Likewise.
All right, and
thank
make
you.
Sure all of you follow
mm-hmm.
Gloria, okay? Don't go anywhere. We got much more coming up for you right after this.
Make you know they don't mean tonight. Joanna, your busy body giving me life, oh. Hey, life, hey. Why you do me like that? Joanna, Joanna. Why you do me like that? Hey, Joanna, Joanna. How you gonna do me like that? Joanna, Joanna. Hey, Joanna. Hey, Joanna.
High Impact Media presents multi-award-winning TV show Positive Progression. To our viewers worldwide, thank you for watching our broadcast. Write us at P.O. Box 20332, Raleigh, North Carolina, 27619. Call us at 800-686-0536. Email connect@highimpactmedia.net. Facebook, High Impact Media. Twitter, @HighImpactMedia. Log on to www.highimpactmedia.net for more info and our list of services.
This beautiful woman by my side, another artist who actually has been on the scene for a minute, and so happy to see her. You know, I've heard a lot of great things about her. You know, now seeing her in person, I'm like, wow, you know, oh yeah.
So
you're
sweet.
Knockout.
Oh, I appreciate it.
But H-Town.
Yes.
Is in the house, no doubt about it. I had to take out my cheat sheet for this one, y'all. Okay, Houston bred, okay? Just gonna read it out like this. San Francisco based,
mm-hmm.
R&B vocal powerhouse, Crystal Tamar.
Yes, sir. Pleasure to be here.
Well, pleasure's all mine.
Oh, you know, sweet.
Crystal, you got a lot of great things happening right now.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good. There it is. Talk to us a little bit about your project.
Okay.
Nowhere. Okay. You've got a great video, all right, that's about to drop. So,
yes.
And the message that you're trying to put out there.
Okay.
Okay. Because you were signed to T-Pain's label.
I was.
One time. So, yeah, give us all the good 411.
Okay. So, I used to be in a girl group by the name of Sophia Fresh. We were signed under Atlantic Records, under the umbrella of Nappy Boy Entertainment, which is T-Pain's
yep.
entertainment company. So we had this whole family of artists thing going on from about 2008 to 2011.
Okay.
And oh my gosh, that's where I really got all my experience, you know, that brings me to where I am today. And so here I am doing my first solo EP.
That's awesome.
And Nowhere is the first official single. And it tells a really genuine story because it's true to me. It's talking about love, of course, because I wear my emotions on my sleeve.
Sure,
I'm an R&B head. I want to talk about love. I want to talk about life.
That's right.
And that's what Nowhere is.
Okay.
Nowhere is telling a story of I'm nowhere without love.
Right.
You know, I've moved here. I've lived here and there. And I'm nowhere if love is not with me.
Right.
So I kind of got to learn that a little bit when I was with T-Pain because I moved about 9 times over 3 years. Mm-hmm. And it's all about, you know, work, which is a beautiful thing in itself. But I come to realize, man, what about love? You know, I want a little time for love. So now I have the opportunity to tell that story in the first single, Nowhere. And yeah, it's That's true to cool. me.
I'm and how do you it. Balance all that? That's right. You know, love is important.
Love is,
you know,
very
sometimes we
important.
Stay so busy doing so much that, yes. you know, we forget that part of it. Sometimes you got to take time out.
Yes.
You know, you got to pause for the cause.
You sure do. You right. really do. And then you would have nothing to sing about, you know?
That's
if you're
going right.
to sing R&B music, you need to be singing about real things. So if you're not experiencing real love and real things, you have no motivation. There's no passion there.
That's right.
So I try to make that a priority.
Sure.
You know?
We've all experienced hurt. You know, you go through those things, right?
Sometimes. Yes.
Sure. We
yeah.
experience the happiness of it, you know. And, you know, and then these days, people are going through so much.
Yes.
You know, depression.
Special times.
This, and, you know, it's unreal.
It's so
very
true.
Very much unreal, you know. So good music, you know, to touch the heart, touch the soul.
Yes.
You know, where, you know, all of your fans can feel it. That's very much important.
Yes.
You know, now where was this shot at?
This was shot in the San Francisco Bay Area.
Okay.
We kind of went around to some of the iconic, like, locations in San Francisco. So we went cool. to the Legion of Honor Museum.
Yes.
We went to the Palace of Fine Arts. If you have never been to the Palace of Fine Arts, you must go there in
yeah.
San Francisco.
It's beautiful.
Oh, my goodness. You wouldn't even think you're in the U.S.
Right.
You know,
right.
it
right.
looks like something you would find in Paris. So we
sure.
went there as well.
Yeah.
And, of course, you have to get the Golden Gate Bridge in the shot.
That's a staple.
Oh my goodness. So it really paints a
picture. Besides all the good food in San Fran.
Oh gosh.
If you don't do nothing but hang out down at the Fisherman's Wharf.
You're good to go.
You know what I mean? You're good to go.
You're good to go.
Okay, there's some good eating people.
Sure is.
All right, there's some good eating in H-Town too.
That's where the best eating is.
There you go.
I have to represent for my people some good food there.
That's cool. Crystal Tegbar right here on Positive Progression. Chris Johnson, your host. We're here in LA and so many festivities going on over the weekend. You know, we travel around the world, and it's always great to bring you wonderful artists like this beautiful woman by my side. Love this creative look. Very beautiful.
Thank you.
Representing us well. Okay, no doubt about it. National recording star, Tia P. Thank you, girl, for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Listen. Tell us a little bit about this look here, the hand on it.
Oh, you like my bantu
knots?
That's
right.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
That's tight, girl. Yeah, just, I'm loving that.
I'm part of, you know, the natural hair care movement.
That's
you
right,
know,
girl.
Natural and healthy. Because you
there
can
you
be
go.
Natural and not healthy.
That's
so,
right.
Like,
it could be something else.
You know,
it's some trifling
you
stuff.
Know, it's some things you like, whoop, yeah, okay. But, yeah, you know, I just try to feel good whenever I roll out, you know.
Yeah,
feel good, look good, be good. Give the energy I want to receive.
That's right. That's right. Talk to us a little bit about your current project.
All right. Well, the main single from the project is an EP called The Wake Up, but the main single that's been getting an incredible amount of love and support is Come Together.
Right.
It's a Beatles classic, as most
sure.
of people should
sure.
know. You should
that's
know
right.
if you don't know.
Yeah,
but,
they know.
Yeah.
They've been watching the video.
Oh, yeah, yeah. If you haven't.
That's right.
Shame on you.
You didn't know. You better watch that video.
You better do
it.
Something
here.
Happened. Yeah.
yeah.
But, yeah, so that's been the single that's been getting a lot of love.
Sure.
The video's been getting love. Shout out to my boy B. Slade, who's on there as well.
Sure.
Phenomenal artist in his own right. Okay. And that has been just pushing the T.A.P. brand, really making a lot of noise, kind of broadening my audience as well because it's
Excellent.
A Beatles original. You
That's
know,
right.
But the way that I flipped it is, it's kind of got a groove.
Yeah.
So it's a little
it's
bit
got a groove.
More,
it's got
yeah.
a little bit of pop in there.
Yeah. So it's
know?
Spread across, but
sure.
not too thin. You
that's
know?
Right.
So it's something for everybody.
And that's important. That's a very, very important point. And we make that very clear right here on the show.
Mm-hmm.
We have a very diverse audience in, you know, various countries. And it's important to let them know, hey, it's all facets and genres of music, and you know when you can diversify that music where you know everyone can gravitate to it, you know,
yeah.
no matter the age,
right.
you know, no matter the color, all of that,
right.
you know, and they can really get into it, you know, it makes for real feel good music.
Yeah, and that's
you
I
know?
Want my music to be a reflection of me. You
yeah.
know, I'm an open type of person. I'm a people person. I love everything and everybody. I want to bring people together.
Sure.
So how suiting for the song like Come Together
Come
to
together.
Be the song and almost like a medicine type song for the world and everything that's going on right now. It's just the timing of it, I think, couldn't have been better. And I'm just really loving the response and how people are gravitating towards it. I couldn't ask for anything more.
So positive words coming from Tia P. All right. You make sure you go out here and support this young lady. Share all of your social media URLs and how folks can get in contact with you.
Absolutely, will do. All right, so you've seen the face. Now you got to know the place. All right, so you can find me everywhere at I am Tia P. I am T-I-A-P. That's on Instagram. That's on Twitter. That is on Snapchat. But a better way to get in contact or just keep up with my dates and everything is my website, which is similarly imtiap.com. Okay, so you got the Instagram, Twitter, website. I think Facebook is Tia P, T-I-A space P period. And all my music is on all platforms, wherever you buy, sell, stream, wherever. Wherever you get your music, Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon Music, you can find the song Come Together as well as the video on YouTube. And shout out to 6X Entertainment and a little something for you. A little
Come Together
t-shirt.
Look at that. That's nice.
Oh, yeah.
You know, got the little autograph
quality.
Going on.
Quality.
Yeah, that is quality. That's the right size. How'd you know my size?
You know, I look better than what's in my ear.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Right on.
Cool, cool.
Thank you, sister.
Thank you.
I appreciate
my brother.
That.
Of course.
Love your creative style. Love who you are, girl. Right. Continued success to you.
Thank you.
All right. And you better go out there and support her. No doubt. All right. Tia P right here on Positive Progression TV. Let's come together. We want to welcome international recording star Ollie Gabriel.
Thank you for having me.
What's up, sir? Bro, I'm underdressed. You know?
Well, they told me I was going to be coming to Positive Progression TV.
Hey, man,
so I was
we appreciate that, man. You look great.
Thank you so much.
A lot going on right now. Tell us a little bit about Songland. Tell us a little bit about your single and a little bit about Ollie Gabriel.
Absolutely. So for those of y'all who don't know me, my name is Ollie Gabriel, and I was recently on Songland, which is an NBC show that is basically gives songwriters the opportunity to pitch their songs to major artists. And I was on the episode with John Legend, the premiere of the show.
That's my boy.
And really, really great experience. I mean, to be able to pitch a song was great. I didn't win the show, but fortunately, I was able to release the song afterwards. As myself, and the feedback has been amazing. So I think the best thing that could have happened for me was not winning.
See how God works.
See how God works. Yeah,
you know.
So I was able. I put the song out as myself, and now we hear radio, and it's really really excited.
We'll be supporting you right here on Positive Progression TV. And if you could share all of your URLs so that people know how to get in contact with you, and reach out to you.
Okay. Well, if you guys want to contact me, please reach out to me on Instagram at Ollie Gabriel. You can reach out to me on Facebook at official Ollie Gabriel. You can reach out to me on Twitter at Ollie Gabriel. So you just search my name, you'll find everything. And also my website is OllieGabriel.com. And that's Ollie, O-L-L-I-E, Gabriel.com.
I'm glad you spelled that, because, you know, you got to get those spellings right, you know.
So it's not like Muhammad Ali,
right?
Like Ollie Oxen Free.
There you go.
All of my people out there watching the show, this is Positive Progression TV. I'm Chris Johnson, your host. Nothing like chilling in West Hollywood, California. This is the beautiful Andes, all right? Overlooking the view up in the hills. That's the Hollywood Hills. If you've never known anything about luxury of the lifestyle of the rich and famous, okay, we just want to show you what it looks like. All you got to do is skin your eyes all around. Okay, it is absolutely gorgeous out here. Okay, and you see, beautiful. So just want to give you a feel of the luxury. The ladies, the celebrities, the VIP parties, you name it. It's nothing like it in the world. Okay, so stick and stay. We've got much more coming up for you. Don't go anywhere.
Making all the dummy tonight. Joanna, your busy body giving me life, oh. Hey, life, eh. Hey. If I tell you, say I love you, oh. My money, my body, now your own, oh, baby. 30 billion for the account, yo. Yeah. Versace and Gucci for your body, oh, baby.
Manager for the Carolinas, okay, and the Southeast market, all right, Mr. Tone Capone, no doubt with Columbia Records.
What's up, Chris? How you feeling, man?
You know, Tone has contributed to the success of so many artists over the years, okay? Never been on the show before, okay? So we always stay behind the scenes, but I'm so glad to have him on the show. Tone, talk to him.
Hey, man, I'm just glad to be here, man, enjoying this L.A. sunshine out here. So great to always run into you. See people still making moves over all the years, man. We've been in this industry. Hey, man, it's just a blessing, man.
It is blessed. It is a blessing.
Oh, yeah.
And how many years has it been for you there, Tone, in the game?
Man, so we're looking at 25 for me, Chris.
25 years. Yeah, yeah. I think we're running up right around the same there. But we 25 years young.
Yeah, that's right.
You know?
That's right.
Yeah. Just give some words of encouragement to all those inspired to go in the industry, to be like a Tony Wallace. Okay, to be an executive, okay, to understand and know the game or whatever the aspirations may be.
Well, I just think that you got to, first of all, understand what it is that you're trying to accomplish and make sure you, you know, you design a plan to get to where you're trying to go and stay focused and stay driven. You know, always be open to asking questions and learn more information. You know what I mean? That's the only way you can get it. And in the industry like the one we work in, things change all the time, so you have to have people that, you know, people that can really help you to stay on track, stay on course to get where you're trying to go. So
that's right.
One thing I can always say is just don't ever be afraid to ask questions and be willing to learn. That's, you know,
that's
everything
right.
else will fall in place.
That's right. You heard it from Tony Wallace. And just so you know, Columbia Records is working a lot of great, great artists. I'm going to let Tony tell you real quick. We interrupted his nice brunch, but I'm going to let him tell you real quick some of the artists that he's worked with and working on now.
Oh, man. So right now, we're really excited about what's happening with Polo G. We got a little TJ. We have a new artist, AMBJ, that, you know, has this little Spanish song that's really getting ready to take off for us. Lil Nas X, we're coming off a number one record, you know, with Lil Nas X. Of course, then we got the Beyonce. We got John Legend. We got Maxwell. We got Juicy J. You know, so we have a lot, man.
Right.
But we're really, really excited right now what we're seeing, you know, what's happening with our records. And don't forget, Raphael Sadiq. Raphael Sadiq got a blazer for you. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So we got a lot to look out for. And Tone, we appreciate everything you
hey,
do
man.
For us right here on the show. You
Anytime.
Know that. All right.
Anytime.
I snuck up on my boy
yeah.
with Brent. All right. Stay tuned. The lovely Miss Deborah Dorsey. I'm so glad to see her.
Hey, thank you guys for being able to make it out.
We appreciate all of what you do for us here on Positive Progression over the years. You know, you've done so much. We thank you for what you've done.
Absolutely. You guys, like you said, you and I have always been like brother and sister.
That's
we take
right.
care of each other. That's what we're supposed to do.
That's
we're
what we're
family.
Supposed to do. That's right. Hey, and this is a Newport News girl.
That's right.
Ah,
I'm just a country girl.
Just tell them some of the posters and where that you've worked at. Some of the labels through the year.
I've been with PolyGram, with Atlantic, Island, worked some Def Jam stuff. Obviously, doing the Empire stuff as an independent, actually. So I have my own company now.
That's just awesome. Deborah, and you're on Empire now. You're working with Empire Records. Some of the artists that you're working with at Empire.
Oh, man. The list list goes on, because, you know, it would be, we got like Trevor Jackson, we got Paul Grizzy, we got Too Short, who's actually on his way here. We got Diggy's going to be doing some things. Sierra Ramirez, you guys can probably remember her from the Fosters. So, yeah, Iggy Azalea got a new project. Wow. Solo Lucci from Hip Hop Hollywood. Lyrica Anderson, Hip Hop Hollywood.
That's a lot of good stuff. This goes on. So Deborah always takes care of us in the Carolinas. All right. Again, thank you so much for everything.
Thank you guys.
You know, continued success in the industry. Okay, you know we love you.
And you know, okay? I love you back.
That's my baby. No doubt. All right. Stick and stay. Don't go nowhere.
What up? What up? This is Brian Dawson, K975 Raleigh, Rockstar Radio. We live in L.A. We're at the Andaz Hotel. It's going down real major. Believe me when I tell you. Shout out to my boy Chris, Positive Progressions, Raleigh in the building, Radio Nation DJs. Salute, baby. Yeah. Yeah.
We want to welcome Maurice Landy here to the show. Bro, let me tell you, you guys are doing big things.
Thank you, brother.
You know, talk to us about some of the priorities. All right, at Empire.
We got, well, let me talk about one signing we just did. Afro B is now signed to Empire.
Oh, excellent.
Afro B.
Yeah.
Also, the young
Afro
man.
Afro B is no joke, bro.
Gonna go, brother.
Afro B, period. No joke, yeah.
And then his man, Bro Timmy, from the show Power, getting ready to launch his record in 2 weeks. So get ready. That's gonna be a, yes, that's gonna be a beast.
Wait for Timmy. I
rolled out. He had to roll out already.
Oh,
rolled
okay.
Out.
Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, man, we got a lot of great things coming down the pike. Got a new Duval record coming.
Okay.
New Fat Joe record coming.
Yes, sir.
Iggy Pop. We got like got a laundry list.
That's
of hits coming.
Yes. Yes. Listen, you better look out. We've been rolling all the videos. Positive Progression. So Maurice, anything you need, you know we're here. Okay. All of our folks out in the Caribbean, UK, New York, Tri-State, and the Carolinas, we're taking care of you.
Beautiful.
Thanks for inviting us out. Okay. Lovely. You know, I like it every year because the vibe is right. You know, it brings the family together, too.
Right. Thank
you know, we've only been doing this for close to 30 years.
Beautiful.
You know,
beautiful.
So, man, it's a wonderful thing, man. Continued success in what you're doing, man. We appreciate all.
You guys being here, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
This is Elle Varner, and you're watching Positive Progression TV.
So, guys, you know what? Wonderful, wonderful event that you do every year. Okay, you've got a lot of priorities on the label itself. Okay, we appreciate what you're doing, man, and just what you're giving to the culture itself. Okay, talk to us about some of the new priorities Empire's putting out. What you guys coming?
We're coming off some really strong releases, actually. We just came off the Tyga album. Just came off a big release for Money Man that was doing really well. We're going into Cycle right now for Iggy Azalea album. We got another XXXTentacion album coming.
Cool.
I got new priorities on the label, like Euro from Young Money.
Okay. Right. What's up, Euro? Come on over here. What's up? All right.
Lot of new young Bay Area talent, Little Pete. Lot of dope shit coming.
Yeah,
lot
bro.
Of dope shit coming.
So we got
a lot of R&B coming, a lot of Afro B coming.
Afro B is heavy these days,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, we just signed Afro B and Rotimi. They're performing at the awards today on the red carpet.
Oh, nice.
And we're doing a lot of work in the UK. I'm signing a lot of Chinese acts. So, yeah, it's just a plethora of things.
My man. And see, this is what we all about, the diversity across the world. You're watching
the
show.
I fuck with the Carolinas, too. I've been all through the Carolinas.
I know you have.
In the car, by myself. Yeah. All through, man. From Winston-Salem to High Point to Greensboro, Raleigh-Durham, Fayetteville, Rocky Mountain, and back around through Greenville.
Okay, we just want to make sure you know.
Yeah.
All right?
You
want to make sure you know. So, we're taking care of you there. We appreciate you, man, and what you're doing. Just in the Carolinas, I thought I would come out here and join her in Hollywood.
See you again.
Okay, you're welcome. Girl, you enjoying yourself?
Yes, I am. It's beautiful.
You having fun?
Yes, this view.
Isn't it nice?
Yeah.
You know, with everybody and the whole crew. It's good to see everybody in there.
So good.
Yeah.
And it's good to see you.
Well, thank you.
I feel like I just saw you, but.
Right, right, right. And check out the outfit. She just let you know she's accessorizing.
Yes.
You know? Beautiful. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you so much.
Continued success to you, all right?
There's always time for the king right here. Beautiful people, it's major. And you show me so much love, and I thank you. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Listen, you know we're all about diversity in the Carolinas, no doubt. Major got his new single out right now.
Love
you better, understand what the merengue and the salsa is all about in the Carolinas.
Yeah.
We thank you so much for watching. We're going to let Homeboy intro us right into it.
What's happening, beautiful people? It's Major, and you're checking out my new single, Love Me Olay, featuring Cass. Yeah.
Every lover way.
Transcends over to many, very diverse, and that's obviously what we express here on Positive Progression. Mm. You know, we have a big fan base in the Caribbean, the Carolinas, the UK, nice. New York Tri-State, mm-hmm. and the Carolinas.
Okay,
where we at? So yeah. It's all about you. So talk to us a little bit about what's been happening with Elle and about the new album.
Okay. Well, thank you for, talking about Elevation. It's the name of the new project. It's an EP, 9 tracks, though.
Okay.
And, yeah, I've been on a journey since Perfectly Imperfect, and I've taken on a lot of new endeavors. I started my own label.
Awesome.
Yeah.
What's the name of it?
212 Entertainment.
Okay.
Okay.
That's cool. 212, February 12th.
The 212.
2 days before the 212. There's a 718 in this.
Well, ah! Yeah.
it's all good. Okay.
But it's a wonderful new addition to my repertoire. Yeah. Taking on the business aspect more. This time around has been challenging but rewarding at the same time, because now I know what's happening. I'm more hands-on with everything, it's very important. Yeah. I executive produced this record.
That is awesome.
Yeah, my dad also. But I found the producers, I A&R'd it,
I did it all. Go ahead on, girl.
I did it all.
The treatments are always wonderful, you mm-hmm. know, a lot of ill treatments, there's a lot that go into it to put the visual aspect together. So we got a nice exotic look here, all right, with the snake. Who came up with this concept?
The snake actually was kind of a surprise when I got on set. She asked me how I felt about snakes.
Were
I was
you scared?
Like, no.
Oh, cool.
I actually, after the video, I researched getting my own. I did. I'm not going to lie, but it's a lot of work.
Women and exotic snakes. And
there's something.
Boa constrictors and, you know.
They're somewhat like therapeutic.
Yeah.
There's the, you know, snake skin is very.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. I know, therapeutic, feels good on the skin, yeah.
It does.
I think you like the way
people pay to have snakes on them just to relax.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This video was actually my first in-studio video.
Wow.
So it was a completely different experience. I'm usually on location somewhere. There's usually like a deep storyline, and a lot of them are in a club or a bar. There's a little theme going on. Okay. But this one is totally different. I'm out of my element in a wonderful way, and it relates to the project Elevation, how it's all about rising up and being fearless and just going with it. So
you're gonna sing a little snippet for me?
Oh yeah.
Do that.
Don't want that kind of love. Don't want that kind of love. No, no. Don't want that kind of love. Don't want that kind of love. No, no. I don't want that kind of love. 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 No, no. Yeah, that's that little flow, that little bounce.
Yeah.
Feeling so good on that kind of love. Wow. Thank you.
But also, get into this choreography, because your girl is dancing in this video. Yes.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Okay. All
yes.
right.
Thank you.
All right. We appreciate you coming on Positive Progression TV. And hey, share your URLs with everybody on your
social media. Elle Varner on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. But also, follow me on Spotify and Apple Music and Amazon and all those good things so you can get the new drops.
That's right. Okay. You better support her and support the arts, okay?
I appreciate it.
She knows how to play the guitar, okay? Come from a musical family background, all right? I'm a sax man.
Oh,
yeah,
nice.
I just want you to know, I've nice. Broken a few reeds in my time.
Okay.
We all go through that, you know?
Yeah.
So that's very much important, you know, just to support the arts. So that's great, you know? Writing and knowing the behind the scenes of it, I think is excellent. All right,
yes.
And hey, that's where the money is, too. Okay, we just gonna be real in this show.
Come on.
All right, let it come on. All right. So if you need to be elevated, okay, then you better get into Elevation July the 12th.
Yeah.
Okay, no doubt. Elle Varner, Grammy Award winner, international superstar. Mm-hmm. Okay, you make sure you support this young lady. Stick and stay.
High Impact Media presents multi-award-winning TV show Positive Progression. To our viewers worldwide, thank you for watching our broadcast. Write us at P.O. Box 20332, Raleigh, North Carolina, 27619. Call us at 800-686-0536. Email connect@highimpactmedia.net. Facebook, High Impact Media. Twitter, @HighImpactMedia. Log on to www.highimpactmedia.net for more info and our list of services.